All right, everyone, welcome to the broadcast this afternoon. We welcome into town the Cowley Tigers for the final two games of this four-game series. On Thursday, we went to Cowley and ended up with a split down there. They won the first game. We won the second one. Doing a little sound check there. Sorry about that. Welcome, everyone. And to get things started today, get a little bit of information here. On Thursday, we went down to Cowley, and Cowley won the first game 3-2, and the Blue Devils bounced back with a 2-1 win in the second game. So the most recent games for the Blue Devils, they swept Labette 20-2, 5-1, 15-6, and 15-5. Then came the two games with Cowley with the loss of 3-2 and the win 2-1. And for the Cowley County Tigers, their final, or their last six games, they beat Butler 18-2 and 19-4. Then they lost to Butler 9-8. They lost to Hutchison 6-5. Then the two KCK games. So fighting for the number two spot on the east side of the bracket in the KJCCC, Johnson County is in first place. They have a 13-1 record. Kansas City, Kansas has a 16-2. Cowley is 12-2 with only 32 hundredths of a winning percentage difference in those two. In fourth place is Fort Scott. They're 10-4. Neosho is in fifth place. They are 12-6. In sixth place, Allen County, they're 5-13. In seventh place is Labette. They're 2-12. Coffeyville is in eighth place. They're 2-16. And Highland is 0-16 in ninth place. So Johnson County is atop the east side of the KJCCC baseball standings. On the west side, Hutchison is in the lead with a 15-3 record. Butler Community College, they are 11-3 in second place. Cloud is in third place with a 12-4 record. Barton is in fourth place. They're 13-5. Dodge is in fifth place with a 9-5 record. In sixth is Seward County with a 6-8 record. In seventh place is Colby with a 3-15 record. Pratt is in eighth with a 2-16 record. And Garden City in ninth place with a 1-13 record. So Hutchison is atop the west side of the division so far this year. So I'm going to hit the starting lineups real quick for... You're not holding off on me, are you? You're not waiting on me. The starting lineups for the Tigers today. Cade Baldridge, the second baseman, will lead things off. Batting second, Jaden McNeely, the shortstop. Batting third, Alex Conover, the right fielder. Batting cleanup, Dane Harvey, the designated hitter. Batting fifth, the third baseman, Keaton Campbell. Batting sixth, Seth Dandridge, the center fielder. Batting seventh, the catcher, Cole Martin. Batting eighth, the first baseman, Dawson Williams. And Ian Luce, the left fielder, will bat ninth with Luke Singleton on the mound. So it'll be Baldridge, McNeely, Conover, Harvey, Campbell, Dandridge, Martin, Williams, and Luce with Singleton on the mound for the Cowley Tigers. Now the starting lineup for your KCK Blue Devils. Leading off, the second baseman, Peyton Basler. Batting second, the shortstop, Gehrig Goldbeck. Batting third, Jackson Mervosh, the third baseman. Batting cleanup, Brady Patterson, the catcher. Batting fifth, Frankie Santiago, the first baseman. Batting sixth, Freddie Nolan, the fourth, is the designated hitter today. Batting seventh in left field, Marcus Dirks. Batting eighth in right field, Tanner Pachorik. And batting ninth in center field, Brady Kern, with Aaron Lewis on the mound. So it'll be Basler, Golbeck, Mervosh, Patterson, Santiago, Nolan the fourth, Dirks, Pachorik, and Kern, with Lewis on the mound. Getting ready to bring the lineups out to the umpires. We'll be ready to get this one started here in about 8 or 9 minutes. I'll be back. All right, welcome everyone to the broadcast this afternoon here on the windy campus of the Kansas City, Kansas Community College Blue Devils here in Kansas City, Kansas. A fairly swift breeze coming out of the south blowing out to left field. You will see that we actually have some folks sitting out on the berm in left field and looking forward to the game from out there on the mound today for the Blue Devils, Aaron Lewis. He has a 3-0 record, a 3.38 ERA, and he is from Kearney, Missouri. Behind him will be Dirks, Kern, and Pachorik across the outfield, left to right. Mervosh, Golbeck, Basler, and Santiago across the infield, left to right. And Patterson is behind the plate. So we are ready for some baseball here.
Leading off the top of the first inning for the Tigers, the second baseman, number 7, Kate Baldridge.
Baldridge will lead things off for the Tigers. He starts the day batting .348. He'll step in to face Lewis. Ball misses low and inside, so 1-0 as we get things started here. Just about 1 minute ahead of scheduled game time. There's a ball headed into left field. So the base hit to lead things off here by Baldridge.
Now batting the shortstop, number 12, Jaden McNeely.
That's going to bring up McNeely. McNeely will step in with a runner on first base. McNeely starts the day batting .402. McNeely, the shortstop. There's a foul ball on the bunt attempt. 0-1 the count. Cade Baldridge with the leadoff base hit past the diving Mervosh at third. Throw over to first, back in safely again is Baldridge.
Part of my job. And I played football for 4 years, so.
The ball backhand by Golbeck over to first and safe at first base. So the return throw doesn't get the double play, but they do get the lead runner in that 6-4 for the first down.
Now batting the right fielder, number 15, Alex Conover.
That's going to bring up Conover. He starts the day batting .353. He'll step in with one out and a runner at first. There's a ground ball headed at Basler. Basler up with it for the 4-6-3 double play to end the inning. So one hit, no runs for Cowley as they get a base hit, but the pitcher, Lewis, faces the minimum with the double play. We'll be back. Thanks for joining me. and Margaret. All right, here we go to the bottom half of the first inning on the mound. Luke Singleton, he has a 4-1 record with a 5.87 ERA. He is from Colorado Springs, Colorado. He's scheduled to face Basler, Golbeck, and Marvosh of the Blue Devils. Leadoff base hit in the top half of the first for Baldridge for the Tigers. Then we get a 6-4 fielder's choice. Couldn't turn the double there. And then on the very next hitter, Alex Conover hits to Basler at second, over to Golbeck, and then return throw to Santiago for the double play to get the Blue Devils into the dugout facing the middle, the minimum. So here we go to the bottom half of the first inning. Loose, Dandridge and Conover across the outfield. Campbell, McNeely, Baldridge, and Williams across the infield, left to right, with Martin behind the plate and Singleton on the mound. Basler will lead things off. He starts the day batting 308. There's a ball hit it up the middle. So both teams have the leadoff man on.
Leadoff single by Peyton Basler.
So that will have Basler at first base.
Now batting shortstop, number 4, Garrett Golbeck.
Golbeck will step in. Golbeck starts the day batting 505. Each team with one hit, both leadoff hitters. Runner at first base is Basler. Lefty on the mound is Singleton for the Tigers. Squares to bunt and pulls it back for a ball. 1-0 the count. Sunshiny day, wind out of the east right now, blowing from right field in. Way outside after he squares to bunt again and pulls back. So 2-0 the count on the shortstop, Gehrig Golbeck. And the bunt by Golbeck right back to Singleton and doubles off Basler.
Now batting the third baseman, number 10, Jackson Mervosh.
So that'll bring up Mervosh. There's a curveball, stays outside. I guess sure looked good by all of us. All of us in the press box had a strike on that one, but nonetheless, it's ruled a ball. There's a strike on the outside corner. Difference between a fastball and a curveball there. Comes the 1-1, strike right at the knees on the inside corner. Mervosh starts the day batting 348. Zabal headed at the shortstop, McNeely. He's up with it and over to Williams for the 6-3 ground out, so both teams face the minimum. End of one, no score.
best Italian food on the planet. Head on down to 8145 State Avenue in KCK to see Renee, Daniela, and the staff. Italian delight, so good.
Biggest boss and I've been in Trillis. I'm a bigger problem when I click with Sprillis. Murder on my mind, it's time to pray to God. My revolver's not religious, the revolution's born. You wanna know my name, then go and tell us all. You wanna know my gang, Suicide Squad. Pistol on my waist, I might make a mistake. Head shot, oh my God, am I crazy? Drugs every corner, this is Gotham City. Killer croc, came to kidnap you to cut out your kidney. Ain't no mercy, got that purple Lamborghini lurking. Rosé, so she know that worth it. Flooded Rolex at the Grammy Awards. They still selling dope, that's those Miami boys. Killers everywhere, it ain't no place to run. Forgive me for my wrongs, I have just begun.
All right, to the top of the second we go. Harvey, Campbell, and Dandridge scheduled up for the Tigers. Harvey starts the day batting 355. He'll step in to lead things off here in the top of the second inning. 1-0 the count to him. It's a foul ball back into the net, so 1-1 the count. Comes the 1-1. Foul ball over the first third base dugout and out of play. So 1-2 the count on the designated hitter, Dane Harvey. It's a ball off the glove of the pitcher. That would have been a base hit if he hadn't have gotten his hand on it. So many times it's deflected and you don't get the out. So that is going to be the 1-4-3 out.
Now batting the third baseman, number 2, Keaton Campbell.
So Keaton Campbell will step in now. He starts the day batting 330. First pitch to him is a strike. Strike called inside corner. The ball headed it, go back. He's up with it and over to Santiago for the 6-3 ground out.
Now batting the center fielder, number 11, Seth Dandridge.
That'll bring up Seth Dandridge. He starts the day batting 411. He takes a strike. Dandridge is the center fielder. There's a ball headed up the middle. And go back up with it. And over to first. So three up, three down here in the top of the second. We go to the bottom of the second. No score. I'll be back.
I let them live for
All right, here we go to the bottom half of the second inning. First game is a seven-inning game. Second game will be a nine. Brady Patterson will step in. Patterson starts the day batting 311. He'll step in to face Singleton of the Tigers. There's a strike outside half of the plate at the knees. 0-1 the count on the catcher, Brady Patterson. Swing and a miss for strike two. Sunshiny day here on the campus of the Blue Devils. 0-2 the count on Patterson. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. That will bring up Santiago.
Now batting the first baseman, number 26, Frankie Santiago.
Santiago starts the day batting 397. He steps in with one out and nobody on. That's low and inside. 1-0 the count. That's a little bit low. So 2-0 the count. I thought both of those would be called strikes, but ruled a little bit low.
Especially with like back to back. Like say like there's a baseball game you guys have next week and that, I bet I'm gonna be like
breaking ball stays up and out. Santiago a switch hitter, Basler and Santiago two switch hitters on the Blue Devils. In tight on the plate is Santiago with this 3-0 count. There's a strike inside corner at the knees. So 3-1, so Santiago now backs off the plate a bit and prepares himself for the 3-1 from Singleton. Foul ball headed for the woods. Down the right field line out of play. So from 3-0 to 3-2. Strike three called. Breaking ball catches the outside corner. So a strikeout and a punch out, and that's going to bring up Freddie Nolan the fourth.
Now batting the DH number 22, Freddie Nolan.
Freddie Nolan the fourth starts the day batting 254. There's a strike. Breaking ball makes it back to the strike zone. That's a little bit low. 1-1 the count. On the designated hitter, Freddie Nolan the fourth. Swinging a miss. 1-2 the count. Two down here in the bottom of the second inning. Scheduled seven-inning game, the first game of the doubleheader. The second one's a nine. Stays outside. Two balls, two strikes, two outs here in the second inning. Just a little bit low. That's a tough pitch to take right there with two strikes. Worked out okay this time for Nolan the fourth. Count is full. The ball hit it at the second baseman, Baldridge. He's up with it and over to Williams for the out.
Score after two innings is still 0-0.
We go to the top of the third, no score.
I'd like to thank BSN Sports for being the official provider of Nike Apparel for all student athletes and TSN, the heart of the game. Leading off the top of the third inning for the Tigers, the catcher, number 9, Cole Martin.
All right, to the top of the third we go, Cole Martin. Steps in. Martin is the catcher. And there's 3-0. There's a strike called. Martin starts the day batting 206. Strike two, so from 3-0 to 3-2. Martin, the catcher at the plate. Just a little bit inside, so a leadoff walk to Martin. That's going to bring up Williams. Williams, the first baseman. He starts the day batting 450. Throw over to first base, back in safely is Martin. And squares to bunt, does Williams, and the ball goes off the tip of the glove. That'll be a pass ball and allows Martin to move to second. So now Williams probably won't be asked to bunt, but you never know, might want to move him to third. And he squares to bunt again, pulls back for 2-0 the count now. Runner at second base. Martin with the leadoff walk, then moved up on a pass ball. There's a little bit low for ball three, so 3-0 the count. Aaron Lewis on the mound for the Blue Devils. He's from Kearney, Missouri. Squares to bunt and pulls it back. Strike one called. 3-1 the count now. Stretch in the 3-1 and the bunt is down. Mervosh has it and over to Basler. So the 5-4 ground out. On the bunt, moves Martin over to third.
Now batting the left fielder, number 22, Ian Luce.
That's going to bring up Ian Luce. Luce starts the day batting 333. One out now. That first pitch is outside, so The first run of the game looms at third base for the Tigers. Is a high chopper going to go over into the dugout of his fellow Tigers? One ball, one strike, one out, one on. So ground ball headed into left field. So an RBI base hit for Luce. And he gets things started here in the scoring manner. So the Tigers score here in the first. So back to the top of the order and Baldridge. Baldridge is from Roth, Oklahoma. One and oh the count. He had a base hit to start the game off for the Tigers. So Lewis looking the second time through the order. There's 2-0 the count now. There's a strike, catches the outside corner. 2-1 the count. Runner at first is Luce. In the dirt, nicely blocked by Patterson. 3-1 the count. Cade Baldridge, the second baseman at the plate for the Tigers. There's a swing and a miss of that pitch. So now 3-2 the count. Throw over to first, close, but back in safely is Ian Luce, left fielder for the Tigers. Runner goes, and the stolen base.
Now batting the shortstop, number 12, Jaden McNeely.
That's going to bring up McNeely. So we have a strikeout and a stolen base. McNeely, the shortstop. McNeely will step in. He's from Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. He'll step in when play resumes. The Blue Devils talking things over with one out and a runner at second base. One run in the top half of the third inning for the Cowley Tigers. They take a 1-0 lead here as things progress in the top of the first. Lewis on the mound for the Blue Devils. McNeely steps in. That's outside for ball one. He grounded to Goldbeck for an out. His first at bat. Nothing going on back there at second base. Luce at second. There's a strike, catches the inside corner at the knees. One ball, one strike, one out, one on, one run in for the Cowley Tigers. Foul ball back and out of play. I think I have misled you. I'm sure that some of you have seen. We have the runner down at. There's a ground ball headed into right field. And that's going to load the bases. Going to bring up Conover. Conover is from Tuttle, Oklahoma. That's low and inside. Breaking ball stays up high. Swinging a miss, 2-1 the count. Loose at third, Baldridge at second. He walked, I called strikeout, he walked. And McNeely at first. So there's a foul ball back to the screen. So 2-2 the count. Now on the right fielder, Alex Conover. He hit into a 4-6-3 double play in the first inning. There's a foul ball down the left field line. That's going to be over into the workout area. Two and two the count. Bases full of Tigers. That's way up high. And it hit the top edge and bounced up in the air. Runners decided to stay. Likely that that ball would have hit the mat at the back and come bounding right back to Patterson, but it hit the top edge and went straight up. 3-2 the count. There's a ball headed to deep right field, and that's going to be extra bases. It will score. He's out at home. So Connor gets the double into right center. One run scores. And then the out on the play at home. That's going to bring up Harvey. Harvey is from Warfordsburg, Pennsylvania. Warfordsburg, Pennsylvania. He'll step in. 1-0 the count now on him. Runners at second and third, 2 outs. It's a ground ball at Golbeck. He's up with it and over to Santiago. So the Tigers get 2 runs on 3 hits, and we go to the bottom half of the third inning. Blue Devils trailing 2-0. Thanks for joining me. All right, here we go to the bottom of the third inning. Dirks, Pechorek, and Kearns scheduled up for the Blue Devils. Dirks, the left fielder.
Leading off the bottom of the third inning for the Blue Devils, the left fielder, number 27, Marcus Dirks.
Dirks starts the day batting 395. Singleton back for another inning of work. There's a strike right through there. Lefty versus lefty here. Luke Singleton on the mound. He's from Colorado Springs, Colorado. Squares to bunt, pulls it back, takes a ball. 1-1 the count as Dirks leads off the bottom of the third for the Blue Devils. They trail by two. Cowley put up a two spot in that top of the third. That sails outside, 2-1 the count. Behind on my bookwork there. Now it says two. There's a strike. Catches the inside corner with the breaking ball. Two balls and two strikes. So ground ball right back to the pitcher. Singleton's up with that and over to Williams for the 1-3 ground out for the first out of the inning.
Now batting the right fielder, number 3, Tanner Pechorek.
That brings up Pechorek. Pechorek starts the day batting 288. Steps in with one out. There's a strike inside half of the plate at the knees. 0-1 the count on Pechorek. Pechorek's the right fielder. There's a strike on the outside corner at the waist. So quickly 0-2 the count on Tanner Pechorek. It's outside. 1-2 the count. Comes the 1-2. Breaking ball just gets a piece of it. So Pechorek earns himself another pitch. We'll do the 1-2 again. Comes the 1-2. Foul ball down the right field line. First two games down at Kansas City, Kansas at Cali. The Tigers took the first game 3-2, and the Blue Devils come back and get the second game 2-1. So a split down there. Today's proceedings will determine probability of second place in the conference. There's another foul ball. Only 32 hundredths of a point separate Cali and KCK for second place. Johnson currently at the top by themselves. A swing and a miss of that breaking ball.
Now batting the center fielder, number 6, Brady Kern.
It's going to bring up Brady Kern. He starts the day batting 377. He'll step in with two outs and nobody on, with his Blue Devils trailing by two here in the bottom of the third. There's a breaking ball right through there. 0-1 the count. return to bunt. Calling a timeout. Does the umpire here at home is calling time. Not sure what he's... I'm saying foul ball, but what's a foul ball from?
What? How did that, what?
That ball can, first bounce can be in foul territory if the second one is in fair. It can be off the plate.
I definitely didn't feel it in foul territory. I don't know what the heck just happened.
I thought it was a glove, you know? So 0-2 the count on Kern. There's a ball headed up the middle. That's grabbed by Baldridge. And over to Williams for the 4-3 ground out. So at the end of three innings, Blue Devils trail 2-0. I'll be back. All right, to the top of the fourth we go. Blue Devils trailing 2-0. It's going to bring up Campbell, Dandridge, and Martin.
Tigers, the third baseman, number two, Keaton Campbell.
Keaton Campbell is from Sepulpa, Oklahoma. He steps in, fouls that one away. One and one the count now. On the third baseman, Keaton Campbell. He grounded out to go back at short his last time up. This is going to be a base hit into center field. So Campbell with the base hit.
Now batting the center fielder, number 11, Seth Dandridge.
It's going to bring up Dandridge. He is from Overland Park, Kansas. He will step in with a runner at first base and nobody out. He grounded out to Goldbeck his last time up as well. Squares to bunt, takes a ball. 1-0 the count. There's a bunt. Foul. Coach Goldbeck with the line drive bunt catch over in the dugout.
That's insane.
Well, Coach, man, that went straight through the net.
Sitting right there at the end of the dugout. Puts the snag on that line drive bunt. Throw over to first. Back in safely over there is Campbell. And the bunt is down. Mervosh is up with that and down to Santiago. But the sack bunt by Dandridge. That'll bring up Cole Martin.
Now batting the catcher, number 9, Cole Martin.
Martin is from Anderson, Missouri. Runner now at second base. There's a ball headed into right field. That's going to be extra bases. So Cole Martin with an RBI double into the right field corner. He's into second base. And the 3-0 lead by Cowley. It's going to bring up Williams. Williams is from Gardner, Kansas. He takes strike one. So the RBI double by Martin. Swing and a miss of that pitch by Williams. Williams grounded out to Mervosh his last time up. Foul ball stays alive, does Williams. Owen to the count. One out, one on, one run in the inning to make it three. It's a ground ball headed at Golbeck. Charges and over to Santiago for the 6-3 ground out. It's going to bring up Ian Luce. He's from Manhattan, Kansas. He'll step in with two outs and a runner at second base. It's a high chopper towards Santiago. He takes it himself, steps on the bag. So the Tigers get one run on two hits. We go to the bottom of the fourth. Blue Devils trailing 3-0. I'll be back. All right, to the bottom of the fourth we go. Blue Devils trailing 3-0. Cowley three runs on six hits. Blue Devils no runs on one hit. Back to the top of the order. Basler, Golbeck, and Mervosh scheduled up to face the Colorado Springs, Colorado native Luke Singleton. That brings up Basler. He is from Lansing, Kansas. Breaking ball stays way outside. 1-0 the count. Basler, his first time up, led the game off with a base hit into center field. Another ball all the way back to the screen. So 2-0 the count now on the second baseman, Peyton Basler. There's a strike on the outside corner. 2-1 the count now.
Let's see. The Royals play the White Sox again.
Breaking ball makes it back to the strike zone. So from 2-0 to 2-2. Stays outside, so 3-2 the count. Basler from Lansing, Kansas. And just gets a piece of that. Earns another pitch by fouling that one away. We'll do the 3-2 again. Luke Singleton on the mound for Cowley. And that's ball four. So Basler with the leadoff walk. That'll bring up Goldbeck.
Now batting the shortstop number four, Garrett Goldbeck.
Goldbeck is from Kansas City, Kansas. That stays up high. Goldbeck bunted a line drive back to Singleton and doubled Basler off as the first two hitters of the inning. We're going to get a visit to the mound. Coach Burrows wants to go out and visit a minute. 1-0 the count. Runner at first. Blue Devils trailing by three here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Anyone that would like to make a donation to the broadcast, you go to 4tees.com. There's a donation page. Any donations goes directly to the broadcast of the Blue Devils baseball this season. 1-0 the count. The visit is over with. Martin staying for an extra couple of words. Now he's headed back. So 1-0 the count, runner at first. There's a strike, breaking ball catches the outside corner. 1-1 the count. Thanks for joining me today, sunshiny day here in Kansas City, Kansas. For those of you that were not able to make it, welcome. Throw over to first. Nothing going on over there. Campbell in on the grass, anticipating the bunt. There's a strike right through there. Comes the 1-2. It's a little bit low on outside. So 2-2 the count now. Nobody out. Runner at first. Go back at the plate. He's the shortstop of the Blue Devils. A ground ball headed into right field. That's going to be cut off by the second baseman. And with a nice diving play, Baldridge up and over to Williams for the 4-3 ground out. And in effect, that works as a sacrifice bunt.
Third baseman, number 10, Jackson Mervosh.
That's going to bring up Mervosh. He's from Lenexa, Kansas. He'll step in with a runner at second base and one out. Coach Goldbeck not happy with the call down at first. Having some words for the field umpire. There's a ball headed down the right field line, and that's going to be foul. Mervosh grounded out to McNeely at short. His first time up. Owen won the count on the third baseman, Jackson Mervosh. Breaking ball stays outside. One ball, one strike, one out, one on. Blue Devils still looking for their first run of the game. Mervosh should like to get that going right here. The foul ball over by the dugout. One and two that count now. Comes the 1-2 from Singleton. Stays outside. Two and two that count. Not sure where that missed, but ruled a ball. Two and two the count. Loose Dandridge, Conover across the outfield. Campbell, McNeely, Baldridge, and Williams across the infield. Martin behind the plate. Singleton on the mound. Another foul ball. So Mervosh has earned a couple of repitches. Two and two the count. Three and two the count. The umpire is flashing at us.
I thought it was three and two, to be honest with you.
Just misses outside. Pretty close pitch to take right there, but ruled a ball. So runners at first and second, one out, and that's going to bring up Brady Patterson. Patterson is from Auburn, Kansas. He will step in. With one out and runners at first and second. Patterson struck out his first time up. He'd like to get something on the outfield grass and get Basler home to get us off that goose egg. There's a strike outside corner at the waist. Breaking ball. Owen won the count. On the catcher, Brady Patterson. That's high and outside. One and one the count. The ball headed deep to left. And out. So Patterson with the three-run home run. To tie this thing up. So one three-run home run right there for Brady Patterson.
Shot by Brady Patterson, and we're tied. And now batting for the Blue Devils, the first baseman, number 26, Frankie Santiago.
So that brings up Santiago.
And man, that looked like a
Santiago takes ball one. Santiago is from Calle, Puerto Rico. It's a ground ball headed at the shortstop, McNeely. And he's up with it and over to Williams for the 6-3 ground out. So two outs now. Now goes to Freddie Nolan, the fourth. Nolan, the fourth, is from Fort Worth, Texas. He'll step in to face Singleton. He grounded out to Baldridge at second base his first time up. There's a strike. Outside half of the plate at the knees. That's low and inside. So both walks end up crossing the plate on that home run by Patterson. Tie this thing up at three. There's a breaking ball right back through there. Started out wide, got back to the plate, one and two the count. Bottom of the fourth inning action. There's a ground ball right back up the middle. And the base hit. Base hit for Nolan the fourth.
A single by Freddie Nolan.
So a runner at first base. That's going to bring up Marcus Dirks will come up. Dirks is from Kansas City, Kansas. He'll step in with two outs and a runner at first base. Runner goes. The catcher was trying to get turned to make a throw, and the ball gets away from him. Dirks at the plate. He grounded back to the pitcher his first time up. Squares to bunt. The bunt is down.
He got it.
And the bunt hit by Dirks.
A bunt hit by Marcus Dirks.
That's going to bring up Pachorik. Pachorik is from Aurora, Colorado. He'll step in with runners at the corners and two outs. That's up high for ball one. Pachorik struck out his first time up. He's up there with two on and two outs. All tied up at three. Little toss over to first. One and oh, the count. Breaking ball catches the inside corner at the waist. One and one, the count. One ball, one strike. Runners at the corners. Pachorik at the plate. And has him picked off and out at home. So the pickoff goes over to first and then to home. Catches Nolan coming to home for the out. But the Blue Devils get three runs on three hits, and we go to the top of the fifth inning, all tied up at three. I'll be back.
25th inning for the Tigers, the second baseman number 7, Cade Baldridge.
It's going to bring up Baldridge back to the top of the order. Top of the 5th inning here. And just barely grazed him for... Well, he thought it grazed him, started to hustle down there, so third base coach will come down and inquire. One and oh the count. Baldridge had a base hit and then walked his second at bat. That misses a little bit outside. Looked pretty good right there, but ruled a ball, 2-0 the count. There's a strike, catches the inside corner. Is that foul ball back and out of play? It's another foul ball over to the left side, now to play. Baldridge has 26 RBI on the year. That's a tie for number 3 in RBI on the team. 2-2 the count. There's a ball headed up the middle and gonna just get out of view of my camera there, but taken care of by Kern. It's going to bring up McNeely.
Now batting the shortstop, number 12, Jaden McNeely.
McNeely is grounded out and had a base hit. There's a strike, catches the outside corner. Dirks, Kern, Pachorik left to right across the outfield. Mervosh, Goldbeck, Basler, Santiago across the infield. Patterson behind the plate. That pitch from Lewis is inside. One ball, one strike, one out. It's a foul ball back and into the screen, so 1-2 the count now. Comes the 1-2, that's up high. 2-2 the count. It's a ground ball headed at Basler. He charges hard and over to Santiago for the 4-3 ground out. That'll bring up Conover. Conover's hit into a 4-6-3 double play and had a double to the right center gap. There's a strike on the outside corner. 0-1 the count. All tied up here at the top of the 5th inning. Tied at 3. That's down low. Tigers with 2 in the 3rd, 1 in the 4th. Blue Devils with 3 in the 4th to knot things up. That misses a little bit low. Looked like a pretty good pitch to me, but ruled a ball, 2-1 the count. There's a strike on the inside corner at the knees. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Top of the 5th inning action. First game of the doubleheader, 7-inning scheduled game. Breaking ball, swung through and missed, so 3 up, 3 down in the inning. We go to the bottom half of the 5th inning, all tied up at 3. that a home game? Is that a home game or away? He leads off the bottom of the fifth here, inning here, all tied at three. Swing and a miss. Actually fouled it into the glove of Martin. 1-2 the count. Pachorik in tight on the plate. And just gets a piece of that. Martin pleading his case that he caught that in the air. Both umpires agree that it bounced first. 1-2 the count. Foul ball back and out of play. A very, very brisk breeze coming out of the east, so blowing straight pretty much in from right field. It's a ground ball headed at Williams. He takes it off the chest. Nice job squaring it up. Steps on the bag for the three unassisted ground out. That's going to bring up Brady Kern. Kern's the center fielder. He's from Lawrence, Kansas.
You got one out of there, right?
Yep. He struck out his first time up. Excuse me, he grounded out to second base his first time up. 1-0 the count. There's a strike outside half of the plate at the knees. One ball, one strike, one out. Each team looking for one run to take a lead here. There's a breaking ball, looked pretty good, but ruled a ball. 2-1 the count. It's a foul ball just wide at third base. Over to take a look was Campbell. And that one in the same spot. We'll do the 2-2 again. That's low and inside. So 3-2 the count now to the center fielder, Brady Kern. Another foul ball that's headed for the soccer fielder, the Woods one. Ready for the eighth pitch of the at-bat. 3-2 the count. Outside for ball four. So a one-out walk to Kern, and that takes us back to the top of the order.
Now batting the second baseman, number two, Peyton Basler.
Basler up there on the right-handed side facing the lefty, as he is a switch hitter. He's had a base hit and a walk so far in this one. There's a strike outside half of the plate at the knees. 0-1 the count. Kern works a one-out walk. had three foul balls with two strikes. There's strike two, catches the inside corner at the knees. Throw over to first. No tag applied by Williams. Singleton in his fifth inning of work. Lefty on the mound for. And we get a diving play by Baldridge. Sends it up to McNeely, and McNeely over to Williams for the 4-6-3 ground out. We go to the top of the sixth inning, all tied up at three. Thanks for joining me. All right, to the top half of the sixth we go. Reminder, this is a seven-inning game. Harvey is up. He takes a strike at the knees, breaking ball by Lewis. Harvey hit in to a ground out back to the second baseman off the pitcher's glove, and then he grounded out to Goldbeck at short as well. 1-1 the count. That's in the dirt, so 2-1 the count. On the designated hitter, Dane Harvey. So one hopper to Mervosh, to Basler over to Santiago for the 4-3 ground out. That's going to bring up Campbell.
Now batting the third baseman, number two, Keaton Campbell.
It's going to bring up Keaton Campbell. He's grounded out and had a base hit. Swing and foul that one away for strike one. That's high and inside. One ball, one strike, one out. Keaton Campbell, the third baseman for the Tigers. There's a strike right at the waist. Outside part of the plate. 1-2 the count. It's a ground ball, headed it, go back. He's up with it and over to Santiago for the 6-3 ground out. So a pair of ground outs, one to the right side, one to the left side, and there's two down, and that's going to bring up Seth Dandridge. Dandridge has grounded out to go back and then had a sack bunt. That misses outside, 1-0 the count. Reminders, first game is a 7-inning scheduled game. There's a strike, catches the outside corner. 1-1 the count. There's a strike, catches the outside corner. 1-2 the count. That's inside and back to the screen.
Oh, that's true. I forgot about that.
Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Cowley three runs on six hits. Blue Devils three runs on four hits. All tied up here in the top of the sixth. That's up high for ball three. 3-2 the count now. Center fielder for the Tigers, Seth Dandridge. The ball headed into left field. That's going to be a base hit. So a two-out base hit by Dandridge. That's going to bring up Cole Martin. He's reached on a base on balls and had an RBI. Double. We're going to get a visit to the mound. We'll take a break, see if there's any changes. Stay with us. Thanks for joining me. All right, the visit is over. Runner back to first is Dandridge. Martin back to the plate. Strike, breaking ball, catches the inside corner. Breaks in toward that back knee, but caught a piece of the plate. 0-1 the count. Aaron Lewis in his sixth inning of work for the Blue Devils. Throw over to first. Backhand the ball in the dirt by Santiago. Little quicker throw that time. Applied the tag by Santiago, but safe. There's a strike on the outside corner. So 0-2 the count on the catcher, Cole Martin. His RBI double was in the fourth. Pitch out, nothing going on. 1-2 the count. Comes the 1-2. It's high and outside. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Toss over to first again by Lewis. Runner goes, and the pitch is high. And going to be safe at second base. So Dandridge with the stolen base. So 3-2 the count. Runner in scoring position, so they're going to put Martin on. So we're going to have a pinch hitter here. Cade Sheldon from Derby, Kansas will pinch hit.
Pinch hitting for the Tigers, number 5, Cade Sheldon.
That misses a little bit low and outside. Sheldon starts the day batting 414. There's a strike at the belt right down the middle. 1-1 the count. Comes the 1-1 in the dirt, blocked nicely by Patterson. So 2-1 the count now. Dandridge at second, Martin at first. There's a foul ball down the right field side. Dandridge with the two out base hit, then a stolen base, then the intentional walk to Martin. The ball headed up the middle. Basler grabs it, steps on second for the unassist out. So no runs on one hit. We go to the bottom of the sixth inning. All tied up. I'll be back. All right, to the bottom of the sixth we go. All tied up at three. Gary Gobeck will step in to lead things off here in the bottom of the sixth for the Blue Devils. Swing and a miss of that breaking ball. Sweeping toward the outside corner. Gobeck has bunt lined back to the pitcher into a double play and grounded out to second base with Baldridge. There's a ball off the foot of the foul ball. Yeah. Loose Dandridge Conover left to right across the outfield. Campbell, McNeely, Baldridge, and Williams left to right across the infield. Martin behind the plate. And Singleton back for his sixth inning of work. Lefty for the Tigers. On to the count on Goldbeck. That misses just a bit outside. 1-2 the count. That's down low. 2-2 the count now. On the shortstop for the Blue Devils, Gehrig Goldbeck. There's a ground ball right at the first baseman. First baseman is now Jarrett Flaggart into play defense.
Now batting the third baseman, number 10, Jackson Mervosh.
That'll bring up Mervosh. Going to get a visit to the mound. Looks like it's going to be a change. We'll get that change. We'll be back. We're all tied up here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Seven inning scheduled game. I'll be back.
Pitcher for the Tigers, number 28, Talon Bagwell.
All right, the pitching change has been made. Talon Bagwell comes in. 0-1 record, 8.22 ERA. He is from Rolfe, Oklahoma. First pitch to Mervosh is a ball. Mervosh has grounded out and reached on a base on balls so far. He's up there with one out and nobody on. There's a strike, catches the outside corner. One ball, one strike, one out. All tied up here in the bottom of the sixth. Seven inning scheduled game, remember. The ball headed into center field. And that's going to drop for the base hit.
A single by Jackson Mervosh. Now batting the catcher. catcher, number 32, Brady Patterson.
That'll bring up Patterson. Patterson will step in, one out. And nobody on. Excuse me, runner at first. Was busy doing a little book work here. Got a little bit behind. Golbeck grounded out to Flaggart on at first base. That's a little bit low for ball one. 1-0 the count. So Patterson struck out in the second and had a three-run home run in the fourth. He was able to tie it up with that home run. 1-0 the count to him. There's a strike outside corner at the knees. One ball, one strike, one out, one on. Bagwell on in relief of Singleton. Just misses a little bit outside. Singleton goes 5 1/3 innings. Gives up 3 runs. That ball out in front of that, swinging. Got work down in the bullpen for the Blue Devils. Two balls, two strikes, and an out. Runner at first base is Mervosh. Fouled back and out of play. So Patterson earns another pitch with that 2-2 count foul away. That's inside. Just under the elbow to not get the hit by a pitch. 3-2 the count now. Foul ball back and out of play. So we're getting ready for the 8th pitch of the at-bat. Bagwell comes in to get a battle with Brady Patterson, the catcher of the Blue Devils. Strike 3 called. Patterson thought it was low, but home plate umpire rings him up for the second out of the inning.
First baseman number 26, Frankie Santiago.
It's going to bring Santiago up. He will now switch across to the left-handed side to face the righty. He'll be up there with two outs and a runner at first. There's a line drive on a one hop to the second baseman Baldridge and over to Flaggart for the 4-3 ground out. So the Blue Devils get a hit, but no runs. We go to the top of the 7th inning. We're all tied up.
Here for the Blue Devils, number 24, Caleb Reed.
All right, to the top of the seventh we go. Blue Devils make the pitching change. Caleb Reed comes in. He has a 1-0 record, a 1.93 ERA. He is from Olathe, Kansas. I believe he went to Olathe South High School. I believe that is correct. And Luce, Baldridge, and McNeely scheduled up for the Tigers. And we go to the top of the seventh. Remember, the first game of the doubleheader for this conference, the first game is a seven-inning game. So that's going to bring up the left fielder, Ian Luce. He's had a base hit and grounded out to Santiago at first. He'll step in to lead things off here in the top of the seventh. Takes outside, ball one, the first pitch from Caleb Reed. So Lewis goes six innings. There's a strike right through there. Gives up three runs on seven hits, does Lewis. That misses just a little bit inside. Two and one the count. It's a foul ball back and out of play. The defense behind Reed is Dirks, Kern, and Pachorik, left to right across the outfield. Mervosh, Goldbeck, Basler, Santiago, and Patterson behind the plate. That misses just a little bit up and out. So three and two the count now. The ball headed into center field. Wrong camera choice there, but nonetheless, Brady Kern takes care of that for the first out of the inning. Yes, that took off the bat really well, but the wind right against it.
Now batting the second baseman, number seven, Kate Baldridge.
So back to the top of the order and Baldridge. He's had a base hit, a walk, and a fly out. So one for three on the afternoon so far. That misses high and outside. 1-0 the count. Just about started to go, did the umpire on that pitch, but it broke inside a little too much. 2-0 the count. Had a little flinch by the umpire. There's a strike on the outside corner. 2-1 the count. Swing and a miss of the high heater. And now it's 2-2 the count. Oh, another almost flinch. 3-2 the count.
That's the first, genuinely bad call. Yeah, I saw it too.
I remember that feeling as a home plate umpire of flinching and then not going ahead with it. There's a foul ball back and out of play.
Just being unsure.
Well, no, just you almost call it and then you don't, and you kind of flinch a little bit. We'll do the 3-2 again. He earns another pitch. And there's ball four. So the one out walk issued to Baldridge.
Now batting the shortstops, number 12, Jaden McNeely.
That's going to bring up McNeely. McNeely steps in with a runner at first base and one out. Runner bluffs but doesn't go. Well, I'll get it right in a minute. Runner at first base is Baldridge. Toss over to first. Not much going on over there. Cade Baldridge with the one out walk. There's the bunt back to the pitcher and down to Santiago for the sack bunt by McNeely. So two outs down to Alex Conover. Conover's hit into a 4-6-3 at a double and a strikeout. He steps in with a runner in scoring position, the go-ahead runner. At second base, to go ahead run. That misses low and inside. Alex Conover, the right fielder for the Tigers. Foul ball off the foot of Conover. 1-1 the count. Top of the seventh inning action. Reminder, this is a seven inning game. Just a little bit low, 2-1 the count. Got a two-hopper to Basler, headed over toward right field, grabs a hold of that and tosses it to Santiago. So we go to the bottom half of the seventh inning, all tied up. We'll be back. All right, to the bottom of the seventh we go.
The bottom of the seventh inning for the Blue Devils, the DH number 22, Freddie Nolan.
Nolan the fourth, Dirks and Pachorik scheduled up for the Blue Devils. Bagwell back for another inning of work. He came in the sixth inning. There's a strike right on the outside corner. Nolan the fourth has grounded out and had a base hit. Base hit was right back up through the box. There's a strike on the outside corner. McNeely with the dive to get that ball going up the middle, but no throw was made. 0-2 the count on Nolan the fourth. In the dirt, not chasing was Nolan the fourth there. 1-2 the count. All tied up at three. Cowley with 3 runs on 7 hits. Blue Devils 3 runs on 5 hits. 7-inning scheduled game, bottom of the seventh. And a swing and a miss for the strikeout. So the breaking ball gets him there.
Now batting the left fielder, number 27, Marcus Dirks.
That's going to bring up Marcus Dirks. He's grounded back to the pitcher and had a bunt hit his two at-bats today. And that ball misses outside. 1-0 the count. On the left fielder, Marcus Dirks. Down a little bit low. There's a strike. 2-1 the count. Squares to a bunt. We'll see if they make that as an offer. Ruled a ball. I thought he kind of offered it that one right there. Didn't have a pronounced pull back of the bat, so 3-1 the count on Dirks. Squares to bunt, takes a strike, so 3-2 the count to Marcus Dirks. Campbell was in on the grass. He now backs up to normal depth at third base. Swing and a miss. So back-to-back strikeouts for Talon Bagwell. Nat's gonna bring up Tanner Pachorik. Pachorik will step in. Two outs here in the bottom of the seventh. Bagwell trying to get us into extras. Pachorik hoping to keep things moving. There's a strike. Pachorik has struck out and grounded out to Williams at first unassisted. 0-1 the count on Pachorik. Foul ball back and out of play. So just that quick, and it's 0-2. Bagwell trying to send this thing into extras. Pachorik trying to keep it going here in the bottom of the seventh. That sails just a little bit low, 1-2 the count. Swing and a miss, and Bagwell sends this thing to extras. He strikes out to the side. So we go to the top of the eighth inning, all tied up. Bagwell strikes out the side. We'll be back. All right, to the top of the eighth we go. Extra inning games here in the first one. We wouldn't expect anything else out of these two clubs. K Cowley took the first one on Thursday, 3-2, and the Blue Devils took the second one, 2-1. Comes the pitch. That's outside to Dane Harvey. He's been out on the ground three times. Once, twice to second, once to short. Swing and fouls that one back to the screen. One and one that count. Top of the eighth inning action, all tied up at three. Want to welcome in the new viewers. The Tigers got two in the third, one in the fourth. Blue Devils got three in the fourth. All tied up here at three in the eighth inning. First game of the doubleheader. On Thursday down at Cowley, we split. Cowley took the first game 3-2. The Blue Devils took the second one 2-1. First game of the doubleheader here today, all tied up. That's down low. 2-1 the count. So ground ball headed at Basler. He's up with it and over to Santiago for the 4-3 ground out. That'll bring now up Keaton Campbell. He's the third baseman for the Tigers. He's grounded out twice to Goldbeck and had a base hit up the middle. There's a strike called right there. 0-1 the count. As Caleb Reed has come in to take over for Lewis. Lewis went six. And called a strike on the check swing. So 0-2 the count. That's up high. 1-2 the count. Keaton Campbell at the plate. He's the third baseman for the Cali Tigers. Breaking ball, strike three called. So Reed with the breaking ball that makes the second out of the inning. That brings up Dandridge. Dandridge has grounded out, had a sack bunt, and had a base hit. There's a strike right through there. Top of the eighth inning action. We're in the extra innings here. Seven-inning scheduled game. There's a strike right through there. These two teams played one-run games down at Arkansas City on Thursday and all tied up right here. Foul ball out of play. Dandridge earns another pitch. Misses a little bit outside. 1-2 the count. The ground ball headed to Basler. He's up with it and over to Santiago. So a couple of ground outs to Basler and a punch out. And we go to the bottom of the eighth, all tied up.
All right.
fiver. That's what it says. All right, to the bottom of the eighth we go, all tied up at three. Kern, Basler, and Golbeck scheduled up.
For the Blue Devils, the center fielder, number six, Brady Kern.
Kern will be up there to lead things off. He grounded out to second base and reached on a base on balls. Takes strike one, called right there, 0-1 the count. Bagwell on in relief. He's from Roth, Oklahoma. Struck out the side in the... There's strike two in the bottom of the seventh inning. Owen to the count on the center fielder, Brady Kern. Just misses a little bit outside. 1-2 the count. Pretty tough pitch to take right there. Foul ball back and out of play. We'll do the 1-2 again. Wind still rather brisk out of the east, blowing in from right field. That's up high. So 2-2 the count. And a swing and a miss, going to head down to first. And Martin down to Flaggart to finish the strikeout.
The second baseman, number two, Peyton Basler.
It's going to bring up Basler. Basler moves over to the left-handed side to hit now. Foul ball back and out of play. Basler has a base hit, a walk, and a hit into a 4-6-3 double play. So 1-for-2 on the day with a walk. 0-1 the count here. There's a strike, catches the outside corner. Basler thought that was out. Campbell was in tight on the grass. He can now back up with less chance of a bunt attempt here. Comes the 0-2. Swing and a miss. So Bagwell with five strikeouts in a row, and that's going to bring up Goldbeck.
Now batting the shortstop, number four, Gary Goldbeck.
Goldbeck has bunted into a double play, grounded out, and grounded to the first baseman unassisted. There's a strike called on the outside corner at the knees. In tight on the plate is Goldbeck. There's a ball headed to the gap in right center and run down by Dandridge. Long run over into right center to take care of that. So we go to the top of the ninth inning, all tied up.
top of the ninth inning for the Tigers, the catcher, number 9, Cole Martin.
All right, to the top of the inning we go. Ninth inning, Martin steps in. Cole Martin, the catcher. Breaking ball stays outside. Martin has a walk, an RBI double, and an intentional walk to his credit in this one. 1-0 the count on him. That misses just a little bit low. So 2-0 from Reed to Cole Martin, the catcher. Pinch hitter in the on-deck circle for the Tigers. There's a strike called. He's not actually a pinch hitter. He came in defense a bit ago and has been on the field. So 3-1 the count. The ball headed up the middle. So Martin with a couple of hits and a leadoff hit. Here's a big hit at the beginning. So Flagger came in to play defense after Shelton did his pinch hit. Then Flagger came in. He will now hit for the first time. Flagger is from Choctaw, Oklahoma.
Now batting number 6, Jarrett Flagger.
Flagger takes a ball outside, squares to Bunnett and pulls it back. We're going to get a visit to the mound from Coach Goldbeck. We'll see if there's any changes. We'll take a short break. We'll be back. All right, the visit is over. Information has been imparted. Flagger steps back in. There's a throw over to first. See if they're going to play some small ball here. That's what you would expect. 1-0 the count. See if Flagger can get the bunt down for the Tigers. And there's a bunt foul, so 1-1 the count. Guessing that the coach will put it on him to bunt again. One run needed to take the lead here. Do the Tigers. There the bunt is down. Santiago down to Basler. And Flagger gets the sack bunt done. So the go-ahead run is now at second base. And that's going to bring up Luce. We're going to get a pitching change. We'll take a break. We'll get those changes. We'll be back all tied up here in the top of the ninth at 3.
pitcher for the Blue Devils, number 50, Bryson Botter.
All right, the pitching change has been made. Reed goes 1 1/3 innings. Excuse me, 2 1/3 innings. And Bryson Votter will come in. Votter is 1-1 on this season, has a 4.91 ERA. He is from Topeka, Kansas. The left-handed hitting in loose. So coach opts for the left-handed pitcher to come in with one out and one on to try and stop the Tigers from getting the go-ahead run. One out, loose at the plate. There's a strike, catches the corner. Loose has an RBI base hit, a ground out, and a fly out. Way outside, nice stab on that ball, because otherwise the runner ends up at third. One ball, one strike, one out, one on. Loose, the left fielder at the plate. There's a ground ball to Basler. Basler over to Santiago for the second out of the inning. The go-ahead run is now at third base and as in the person of Cole Martin. So back to the top of the order and Baldridge, the second baseman. He's had a base hit, a fly out, and a couple of walks in this one. One for two on the day with a couple of walks. That's outside. 1-0 the count. Votter on in relief of Reed and Lewis. There's a swing and a miss. Votter trying to keep this thing tied up here in the top of the ninth. Misses just a little bit low and inside, 2-1 the count. So a base hit, a sack bunt, and a ground out. Runner at third and two outs. Stays outside. So 3-1 the count on the second baseman, Cade Baldridge. Swing and a miss. Count goes full.
Come on, Votter.
There's a foul ball back to the screen. Baldridge earns another pitch. The ground ball hit it at Basler. with the glove and the underhand out of the glove over to Santiago to send this thing to the bottom of the ninth. We're still tied. Blue Devils looking to walk this thing off right here. All right, to the bottom of the ninth we go. Still tied up at three.
The third baseman, number 10, Jackson Mervosh.
Mervosh will step in to face Bagwell. That's low and outside, ball one. Bagwell has five strikeouts and a flyout since he came in. That misses a little bit low. Looked pretty good to me right there, but ruled a ball. Bagwell is from Roth, Oklahoma. There's a line drive headed into left field. Kind of turned loose around and so forth, but he recovered enough to make the play. So Mervosh hits it hard, but is out.
Now batting number 32, Brady Patterson.
So that will bring up Brady Patterson. Patterson has a strikeout, a three-run home run, and called out on strikes. I'm sure he'd like to put another one over the fence right here. There's a strike. Just walk this thing off would be something he'd like to do. 0-1 the count on him. There's a strike outside half of the plate. So quickly 0-2 the count. On the catcher, Brady Patterson. Bagwell came in the sixth inning. Swing and a miss of the high heater. So Santiago will come up with two outs.
First baseman, number 26, Frankie Santiago.
Frankie Santiago, he has been called out on strikes and grounded out to short and second in this one. There's a ground ball hit it right at the second baseman, Baldridge, and over to Flagger for the out. So we go to the top of the 10th inning. We're all tied up still.
10th inning for the Tigers, the shortstop, number 12, Jaden McNeely.
Top of the 10th we go. McNeely, Conover, and Harvey scheduled up. Vauder back for another inning of work. Not sure where that missed, but nonetheless, 1-0 the count. There's a strike on the outside corner. 1-1 the count. Misses inside. 2-1 the count. First game of the doubleheader today. There's a line drive just past the diving Santiago. So a leadoff base hit by McNeely. That'll bring up Conover. Conover has hit into a double play, grounded out, had a double and a strikeout. Throw over to first, nothing much going on over there. Can see by the wind on the jerseys and the move around of the camera that the wind is really cooking. There's a strike called on the right fielder, Alex Conover. Throw over to first. Swing and a miss, so quickly 0-2 on Conover. Misses a little bit outside. 1-2 the count. Strike three call just catches the outside corner with that breaking ball. That'll bring up Dane Harvey.
Now batting the DH number 50, Dane Harvey.
Harvey is 0-for-4. He has grounded out four times. Toss over to the first. Back in safely over there is McNeely. One out, one on. Top of the 10th inning action. Ball misses outside. 1-0 the count. The format is games on Thursday at one site, then on Saturday at the other, doubleheaders. First games are 7. There's a foul ball back to the screen. The second game is a 9. But when a game goes into extra innings, it becomes the 9-inning game. So the second game of the doubleheader will be a 7, as it was down there on Thursday. There's a swing and a miss, 1-2 the count. Harvey down in the count, 1-2 to Vauder. There's a ground ball down to Santiago, but foul. So Harvey earns another pitch. 1-2 on him. Throw over to first. McNeely with the leadoff base hit. Called out on the strikes is Conover. There's a high chopper and the double play. So Basler comes over by second, steps on the bag, tosses it over to Santiago for the double play. And we go to the bottom of the 10th inning, still tied up. Thanks for joining us. All right, to the bottom of the 10th we go.
For the Blue Devils, the DH, number 22, Freddie Nolan.
Freddie Nolan, the fourth. He's grounded out, struck out, and had a base hit. There's a strike outside half of the plate at the knees. Nolan, the fourth, Dirks and Pachorik scheduled up for the Blue Devils. Need to wear that thing, Mr. Nolan, the fourth. Jumps out of the way of that one. 1-1 to count. That's so hard to do, though. Some people are better at than others. I was never very good at that. And ruled a ball on the check swing. 2-1 the count. Nolan, the fourth, at the plate. Bagwell back for another inning of work. That's up high. Another check swing ruled a ball. 3-1 the count. It's a ground ball at the second baseman, Baldridge, and over to Flaggart for the 4-3 ground out for the first out of the bottom of the 10th.
Now batting the left fielder, number 27, Marcus Dirks.
That's going to bring up Dirks. Dirks is grounded back to the pitcher, had a base hit, bunt, and struck out. There's a ball late swinging down the left field line, but foul. That misses a little bit outside. And a bunt's going to be foul. Several players on this team, they can have a bunt attempt virtually any time. And Marcus Dirks, the left fielder, is one of those. 1-2 the count on him. That's up high. 2-2 the count now.
Yeah, but then the umpires will probably get free food after, so it's probably like $10 worth.
That's up high for ball three. So 3-2 the count. Three balls, two strikes, one out, all tied up at three here in the 11th. And strike three called on the inside corner. That's going to bring up Pachorik.
Now batting the right fielder, number three, Tanner Pachorik.
Pachorik steps in with two outs and nobody on. There's a strike right through there. 0-1 the count. And the bunt back to the pitcher, Flaggard down to, Bagwell down to Flaggard for the ground for the bunt out. We go to the top of the 12th inning, still tied at three. My apologies, I said the 12th. I should have said the 11th. So to the top of the 11th we go.
Leading off the top 11th inning for the Tigers, the third baseman, number two, Keaton Campbell.
Campbell with the swing and the miss. Campbell, Dandry, Jan Martin scheduled up. One and one the count. There's a strike, 1-2 the count. Strike three called. So Campbell called out on strikes his last two at-bats. That's going to bring up Dandridge. Going to have a pinch hitter here. Number eight, Hunter Alford. First pitch to him is a strike. That's a little bit low, 1-1 the count. Alvord is coming back from a sprained ankle, was cleared to play. Didn't know if he was going to get an opportunity, but it looks like he will. One ball, one strike, one out. That's outside to Alvord. 2-1 that count. In the dirt. 3-1 the count now. There's a ball off the pitcher's leg, and that's going to be a base hit off of Vauder. So Vauder takes the ball off, and that's going to be a base hit for Alvord. It's going to bring up Cole Martin. He's had a double and a single and a couple of walks, one of the walks intentional. That's up high, 1-0 the count. Alvord with that base hit. He's from McPherson, Kansas. There's a strike. Breaking ball makes it back to the strike zone. One ball, one strike, one out, one on. We're in the 11th inning. A lot of ones showing up there on the board. There's a strike. Inside corner at the knees. Martin not liking that call. That's been a strike all day today. Here comes the 1-2. Going to toss over to first. Back in safely is Alvord. And a swing and a miss of the high heater. So a punch out, a base hit, and a strikeout. And that's going to bring up Flaggart.
Now batting number 6, Jarrett Flaggart.
Flaggart will step in with 2 outs and a runner at first base. Stays outside, way outside. 1-0 the count. It's high and outside, 2-0 the count. Vauder on in relief of Reed and Lewis. Lewis started the game and went 6. Reed went a couple. Vauder on the mound. Pretty good looking pitch right there. Ruled a ball, 3-0 the count. It's when you got to have a short memory when you think you've got a strike. You got to come back and come down the hill. There's a strike. 3-1 the count. There's times in the game of baseball that you need that short memory. Here comes the stretch in the 3-1 from Vauder. Going to go to first instead. Back in safely is Alvord. Alvord at first base. He ripped a line drive off of Vauder's leg. And that's ball 4. Coach of Cowley's going to call Luce down to have a visit with him. Luce has had an RBI base hit, a couple of ground outs to the right side, 1 to second base and 1 to first base, and a fly out over into right center. That was a ball run down by Brady Kern. So the go-ahead run at second base. Two outs. Misses a little bit low. There's a strike right through there. So Alvord at second base. Flaggered at first. Loose at the plate. Two outs. Stays up high. Two and one the count. Just misses a little bit inside. Three and one the count. Vauder trying to get the Blue Devils in for their half of the 11th. There's a strike right through there. Three and two the count. So the runners on the base paths will be going. Three balls, two strikes, two outs. Base on balls, curveball stayed up high. So back to the top of the order. So the umpire gives his one warning to the Blue Devils about the strikes calls. Or they're the lack of.
Number seven, Kate Baldridge.
Baldridge will step in. Missed a little bit down low. Baldridge has a base hit, a couple of walks. A nice charging play by Basler. We're going to get a visit to the mound. We'll take a quick break, see if there's any changes. Trying to get a winner for this one. We're in the top of the 11th. We'll be back. All right, the visit to the mound is over. 1-0 the count on Baldridge. Outside, the zone sure seems to have tightened up, but nonetheless, 2-0 the count. It's outside for ball three, so 3-0 the count on Baldridge. Comes the pitch from Vauder. There's a strike on the outside corner. 3-1 the count now. And a foul ball, so from 3-0 to 3-2. So the runners will be off with the pitch. The bases are full of Tigers. Top of the 11th inning. all tied up at 3. And ball 4. So a base on balls to untie this game. So we will get a pitching change. Tigers go up 4-3 on the base on balls. We'll get that change. We'll be back. All right, the pitching change has been made by the Blue Devils. Dalton Smith from Raymore, Missouri will come in. He has a 3-1 record, a 2.63 ERA in 13 2/3 innings pitched. He will take over with the bases loaded, 2 outs, and the Blue Devils trailing by 1 on the base on balls. RBI for Cade Baldridge. We'll be back. All right, after somewhat of a delay here, it had something to do with umpires, but not exactly sure what it was. The pitching change was made. Dalton Smith had warm-up pitches and then keep warm pitches for quite the time. Not sure what happened. And I'm sure you're thinking restroom. I don't know that that's what it was. 1-1 the count now. Jaden McNeely at the plate. He's had a couple of hits, couple of ground outs, and a sack bunt. There's a foul ball into the net. So 1-2 the count. One ball, two strikes, two outs. One run lead on the base on balls with the bases loaded for the Tigers. That's outside. So two balls, two strikes, two outs. Smith on in relief of Vauder. It's a foul ball down the right field line and out of play. We'll do the 2-2 again. High and inside. So 3-2 the count. Bases loaded. Runners will be off with the pitch again. Line drive right at Santiago for the out. So to the bottom of the 11th we go. Cali Tigers leading 4-3. They took the lead there in the top half of the inning on a base on balls with the bases loaded. So it looks like a pitching change. We'll get that information. We'll be back. The Blue Devils need one to keep this thing going, two to walk it off. We'll be back. All right, to the bottom of the 11th we go. Pitching change was made by the Tigers. Barrett Morgan, he has a 2-0 record, 3.26 ERA in 19 and a third inning pitch. There's a strike right through there. He's from Stillwater, Oklahoma. Turn up for the Blue Devils. 1-1 the count to him. Kern has grounded out, reached on a base on balls, and struck out. There's a ground ball headed up the middle. Second baseman Baldridge up with that over to Flaggard for the 4-3 ground out. So So back to the top of the order and Basler. Basler has a base hit, a walk, grounded into a double play, and a strikeout. He's up there with one out and nobody on. There's a strike called. 1-0 the count. That was about the height of the strike that walked in the run right there. 0-1 the count. Foul ball back and out of play. Luce Dandridge gone over across the outfield. Campbell McNeely Baldridge flaggered across the infield. That's up high. Martin still behind the plate and Morgan on in relief of Bagwell and Singleton. 1-2 the count. Morgan to Basler. There's a foul back. He earns another pitch there. We'll do the 1-2 again. That's up high. 2-2 the count now. One out as Basler hits here in the bottom of the 11th. Blue Devils trailing by one. It's a high fly ball. And that's going to be taken care of by the second baseman, Baldridge. So the Blue Devils down to their last out.
Now batting the shortstop, number 4, Garrett Goldbeck.
That's going to bring up Garrett Goldbeck. He's 0-4 on the day, takes ball one. Bunted a line drive right back to the pitcher for a double play. Grounded out twice and a fly out to right center. 1-0 the count to him. There's a strike called. 1-1 the count to Goldbeck. Foul ball back and out of play. So the Blue Devils down to their last strike for the moment. Swing and a miss of the high heater. And the Cowley Tigers take the first game of this doubleheader today. The third game of the series, 4-3 win in 11 innings. We'll be about 20 minutes to 25 minutes coming back. The next game will be a 7-inning game. Cowley takes this one 4-3. We'll see you in a few.